In this lecture, basically, we are just focusing about what are basically the antennas and what are their attributes used for the satellite communication. So, like we talked about that what are basically the orbits. We talked about what is the effect of atmosphere. We talked about what are the losses. We talked about what are the basically other attributes, which are the natural phenomena, somewhat like the eclipse, Earth eclipse, it happens. Sun transit outage, it happens. So these are the very common phenomena that happens. So we talked about some natural phenomena and some phenomena that has been created because of the effect generated between the communication. So we talked about all these ones. Now the most important part to communicate between two satellite or to communicate from satellite to Earth and to just give actually the application is what exactly? That is important, the antenna. So here, as you all already gone for that, you have talked about a great about the antennas. So that's why we are just taking a little review of this one, what exactly kind of antennas to be used in satellites. So moving in this direction. So first of all, let's begin with this one. So antenna, you all know, so no need to just tell it again what exactly it is. It is a metallic structure that captures or transmit radio electromagnetic waves. So exactly any simple structure, if you have any piece of conductor, that conductor has a capacity to receive and radiate. Every conductor has a ability to receive or radiate, but what to receive and what to radiate, that depends upon its shape, dimension, structure, its material, its aperture, all things descend. Like you want to communicate in some languages or some frequencies, but that frequency is not compatible with this one. So every piece of conductor is an antenna, but that every piece of conductor or antenna is not useful. So we have to make such kind of a structure for what frequency we are looking for what frequency we are trying to work, that frequency should be radiated or captured by the antennas. This is exactly a very simple theory. So antennas comes in all shape and size, from little ones that can be found on a roof to watch TV to really big ones that capture signals from the satellite millions of miles away. So that's very interesting. If you're talking about the satellite antenna, so one of the very simplest kind of antenna you always see at your home. So now everybody has that satellite antenna at their home. That is the D2H antenna. That D2H antenna is basically a very, very good kind of example we all have in daily life. The antenna transmit and receive the modulated carrier signal at radio frequency portion of the electromagnet. So we know that if suppose we are looking to just have a long haul communication, so under this long haul communication, it's most important that antenna must able to radiate for a long distance. The antenna must be able to radiate for a very, very long distance. So for the long distance, we need to go for the modulation properties that we all done. So in the communication, it is important to have a all modulations theory. So now the thing is coming, how an antenna work, what is basically the process to an antenna? The radio waves travels through the air at the speed of light. We know the electromagnetic wave radiation speeds. When the wave arrive at the receiver antenna, they make electron vibrate inside it. Electromagnetic electric field comes up and we have a piece of conductor. In this piece of conductor is electrons. They are having the electron and around them we have electromagnetic field. And when this field come up, the electrons will try to start vibrate. This produces an electric current that recreates the original signal. So this is very same as we talked about initially in the Faraday's law. What we did, we have a simple piece of solenoid and we were moving that solenoid in the magnetic field. And suddenly we got that within the solenoid, current was flowing. Aisa hua tha, humne Faraday's experiment mein kiya tha. Bas wahi hai. Phenomena simple hai ki jab bhi kisi conductor, piece of conductor ko varying magnetic field mein, varying electric field mein rakha jayega, to unke electrons ke upar forces lagenge. अब फोर्सेस लगेंगे तो वे इलेक्ट्रॉन इधर से उधर भागेंगे जब भी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एक जगह से दूसरी जगह भागेंगे तो वी कैन से दैट देयर इज अ फ्लो ऑफ करंट सो व्हाट हैपेंस we are having a piece of conductor, kind of this one. When it is put in a magnetic electromagnetic field, this electromagnetic field is creating electron vibration, electrons start flowing, and the current starts. So that happens in the antenna. So this is a very simple theory how an antenna works. Moving up, the antenna is the most visible part of satellite communication. For satellite communication, frequency ranges from 0.3 gigahertz to 30 gigahertz. See, so most important part we have already talked about the antenna is here. And what exactly the range of the frequency? So somewhat it starts from 0.3 to 30 gigahertz. It means it's working on a microwave frequencies. A variety of types are used in the satellite communication. The most widely used narrow beam antennas are the reflector antennas. Same, we have a D2H1, that is the same one. So those are the very common antennas. So a variety of type of antenna used in satellite communication, the most widely used narrow beam antennas, that's an important line. For full earth coverage from a geostationary satellite, a horn antenna is used. Now the things is here, we are talking about basically the antenna. So antennas are not only an important factor for the earth station, but it is an important factor for the satellite too. क्योंकि एंटीना ही अपने आप में वो डिवाइस है, वो चीज है जो बात करेगी. किससे बात करेगी? एंटीना से. द एंटीना इज टॉकिंग टू अनदर एंटीना ऑन अर्थ और सैटेलाइट. सो इट मींस द सैटेलाइट एंड अर्थ कैन नॉट टॉक विद ईच अदर, कैन नॉट कम्युनिकेट विद ईच अदर अंटिल अनलेस दीज टू फैक्टर्स, द एंटीना एट द सैटेलाइट एंड द एंटीना एट द अर्थ विल बी टॉकिंग टू ईच अदर. So that creates the communication in between that. So they are talking to. So we have to take care about this antenna, and this antenna has to be synchronized. So talking about this one for the satellite purpose. So this antenna, who is at the satellite, must be capable to coverage of Earth. So full Earth coverage from a geostationary satellite, horn antenna is used. Because the horn antenna gives a spiral kind of a wave, is directly rotated this one. So if geostationary satellite is moving continuously, so it's just giving like this one. So it is fixing up the rays, and geostationary satellite is moving is like that. So it is covering this. So this is basically the way. Now, if suppose we are talking about the functioning of an antenna, one more important part comes, which is the payload function. So we have to understand about this terminology until and unless we have idea about this payload, what exactly the payload, because designing, maintaining an antenna, we have to work with some kind of a things that are really important for an antenna before deciding, before designing of it. So this payload function is nothing but it receives signals from ground, amplify signals, convert carrier frequency from uplink to downlink bands, transmit signals to ground. So talking about on what factors this payload function is deciding, receive signals from ground. So exactly it happens. So whenever we have an antenna, it might be possible you might be receiving the signals from the ground itself. Second, it amplifies. Amplification process it does. Convert carrier frequency from uplink to downlink. That is important, because if an antenna is transmitting, then definitely it takes place the uplink frequency, which is going from Earth to satellite, and the frequency which is coming from satellite to Earth must be different. So that interference does not happen. And if interference you want to avoid, so you have to create two different frequencies. So that conversion has to be take place. It means my voice, I'm talking to you. If suppose I'm using internet, and anyhow this internet is used with the help of a satellite communication, anyhow, just taking an example, then my voice first modulated on different frequency to reach the antenna. And that antenna is transmitting to the satellite. And when this coming back and reaching to you people, at that situation, this download frequency will be different. So the same voice, same signal is modulated on different frequency to just avoid the interferences. So let's see, it's a very, very simple type of diagram. Just have a look of it, how exactly it happens around this one. So starting from this one, from the first point, so first of all, what we have information with us, exactly. Because ultimately, unless we have any information, any signal with us, what is the need of just transmitting this? No need. So we have information with us, and that information is first encoded. encode it in desirable format. Because nowadays, what do we have? We have a digital communication. And digital communication have a variety, have a facility to just give a kind of a rectification, to give a kind of a filtration, and everything is there. So when we have this sort of facility of basically encoding, so encoding makes it digital. Then we go for the modulation process. If we have a digital communication, we go for the digital modulation techniques like ASK, PSK, QP, SK, like something. Okay, so digital modulation. Now it comes up after conversion. We have to decide this one. After conversion, we have to decide this up converter frequency. So up converter is nothing. It is converting frequency on the out frequency of what going up. And then after, we have up amplifier. The high power amplifier is required because we have to send a signal from earth to satellite. And you know, lot of factors are there. They are opposing, they are creating obstructions, they are creating hurdles in the path of the communication. So jab itne sare hurdles aate hain, itne sare obstructions aate hain, itni sari parishaniyan aati hain, so during all those hurdles, all those obstructions, a requirement of high power signal is there. So that's why if you see here the first information, then we have encoding of this one, then we modulator, we modulate the signal, then we have a up converter, then we have a high power amplifier. Then we are transmitting this through antenna. So if you see here, we are transmitting specifically, those are communicating with the space and called as earth stations, earth stations hote hain. On earth stations, they have a very big antennas with a great parabolic reflectors. Bahut bade bade space hote hain, if you see there. Then it is directly sent to the satellite. And here on the satellite, that received by the satellite transponder. The transponder is basically nothing a device which transmit and respond. It is called as a transponder. It transmit as well as it's respond to. So transmit and the response both exist simultaneously. So it receives and then finally converts and modified or just condition the signal. It might be possible ki signal mein koi na koi problem aa gayi ho during this process. So is signal ko upar jaane ke baad mein wo jaake satellite pe jaane ke baad mein transponder usko condition bhi karte hain, change karte hain frequency ko. Amplification required hota hai to it does the amplification and basically the ARP. So finally, all these things helps to just put a particular frequency on a downlink. Then it goes to the downlink, and downlink sends it to the again back to the place where it is required. Antenna se jahan usko bhejna hai, usko wahan par bhej diya. So receiver pe aata hai low noise block converter because it is coming from the satellite, coming from the atmosphere. So it might be possible. यहाँ पे नॉइजेस क्रिएट हो जाएंगे. सो नॉइज ब्लॉक कन्वर्टर लगा दिया, रिसीवर एंड डिमोड्यूलेटर लगा दिया, डिकोडर कर दिया, देन फाइनली यू आर हैविंग आउटपुट. सो सपोज एनी हाउ वी आर हैविंग अ सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन फॉर द वॉइस सिग्नल. सो दिस वॉइस इज बेसिकली नथिंग बट इंफॉर्मेशन इनपुट, फिर इसको कोड कर दो, फिर इसको मॉड्यूलेट करा दो, मॉड्यूलेट कराने के बाद जिस फ्रीक्वेंसी पर रिक्वायर्ड है कन्वर्ट करो, हाई एम्पलीफिकेशन करो, ऊपर जाके कंडीशनिंग होगी, कंडीशनिंग होने के बाद में डाउनलिंक फ्रीक्वेंसी में कन्वर्ट होगा, रिसीव होगा. अगर इस आवाज के साथ में कुछ नॉइजेस भी आ गई हैं, सम नॉइजेस वर देयर बिकॉज़ ऑफ द अनवांटेड सिग्नल, हटाइए, रिसीव करिए, डिमॉड्यूलेट करिए, डिकोड कर दीजिए और फाइनली गेट द आउटपुट. सो दिस इज एग्जैक्टली द ऑल अबाउट द होल प्रोसेस ऑफ ट्रांसमिटिंग ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन एंड रिसीविंग एन इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम सैटेलाइट विद द हेल्प ऑफ एन एंटीना. So if like you have any doubt, you may ask. Then let's we move ahead. Now coming up, like we just got the process how this communication takes place. Now the second is here. If suppose such kind of a communication happens, then how and what are the other types that can create a such communication in a good way? So this is called as a horn antenna, parabolic reflector, and double reflector antenna. So basically these are the antennas generally used within the satellite communication. So the horn antenna, parabolic reflector antenna, and a double reflector antenna, these are the three basic categories. Talking first about the horn antenna, Horn antenna is a simple example of an aperture antenna that provides a smooth transition from a waveguide to a larger aperture that couples more effectively into space. So you have seen that the horn antenna, you have already seen that, you have already gone through the antenna and wave propagation. So if you study about the different type of antenna, you see a such kind of a structure generally, which is called as a horn structure. If you see, this is, it's a very big size horn antenna. So you see here, like this is the basically part. Here we have a waveguide and this is opening mouth. So it has a basically, actually nothing it is doing. We have one thing in which the microwave travels is called as waveguide. And now we need a structure that microwave travels in a waveguide and how these are coming out from the waveguide. To make it out from the waveguide, we have to have a structure that couples it in the free space. So coupling this into the free space basically requires the horn type of antenna. So this is a kind of an antenna which couples microwave energy to free space. So if you see here, generally you have already, it's a pyramid like structure is there, square shape is there, conic structure is there. It's a very same as we have the horns. जैसे हम लोगों ने देखे ना हॉर्न्स होते हैं लाइक लाउड स्पीकर्स होते हैं वेरी सेम स्ट्रक्चर्स दे हैव इनिशियली दे आर हैविंग अ शार्प एज बिकॉज़ इट इज कनेक्टिंग विद द वेवगाइड स्टार्टिंग में द वेवगाइड से कनेक्ट हो रहे हैं देन ओपनिंग इट माउथ फिर इसका माउथ खुलता चला जाता है एंड मैचिंग विद द इंपीडेंस ऑफ द फ्री स्पेस इट लुक्स लाइक दैट हॉर्न एंटीनाज आर यूज्ड डायरेक्टली एज अ रेडिएटर अबाउट सैटेलाइट टू इल्यूमिनेट कंपैरेटिवली लार्ज एरियाज ऑफ द अर्थ And they are also widely used as a primary feeds for reflector type of antenna, both in transmitting and receiving. So they are perfectly used in the transmitter as well as in the receiver. So exactly, once we are talking about this one horn antenna, so horn antennas are the perfect radiators. They can directly be used with the coupling with the waveguide. Waveguide se couple karo. Couple karne ke baad mein free space mein use kar lo. Or important hai. कि दैट कैन यू डायरेक्टली यूज विद द प्राइमरी फीड जो प्राइमरी फीड है उसके साथ आप डायरेक्टली इसको यूज कर सकते हैं यू कैन यूज इट डायरेक्टली विद द प्राइमरी फीड है ना और रिसीवर और ट्रांसमीटर दोनों ही केस में ये कंपैटिबल है सो नो इश्यू एट ऑल इन द केस ऑफ द रिसीवर एंड ट्रांसमीटर सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट दिस So this is a very, very interesting kind of a horn antenna. If you see here, the people are standing and what exactly the size of this one. So from here, we are providing a waveguide here, the waveguide, and this is providing a great huge frequencies in the free space to connect with the satellites. Then talking about what are the basically the advantage of the horn antenna. No resonant element operate over the wide range of frequency. Usable bandwidth 1 gigahertz to 20 gigahertz, gain range up to 25 dB. So resonant नहीं होता इसमें. Operate over wide range of the frequency can be capable. ये important होता है कि मतलब आपने एक antenna लिया, and if you see this antenna is only working for small range, like 3 से 300 के बीच में, 3 से 30 के बीच में काम करेगा. That is called as a small range antenna. लेकिन if it is working for the 3 to 300, it's a wide range antenna. So that's why it is being said. So it's a great bandwidth. It has a 1 gigahertz to 20 gigahertz. Or gain. Gain is also very much important because gain is that factor which keep binding the energy in the desired direction. Antenna se nikalne wali energy ko agar aap ek desired direction mein bandhna chahte hain, so that phenomena is basically called as a gain. So gain ranges up to 25 dB. So this is also a very good advantageous point that's perfect here. So all of these are the advantage of the horn antenna. So that may be generally asked many times. What are basically the advantages of the horn antenna? So you can easily discuss about that. Now coming up the next one, which is the parabolic reflector antennas. So along with the horn antennas, we have already seen the parabolic reflectors are there always in the D2S. So parabolic reflector, you all know, are widely used in the satellite communication system to enhance the gain of antenna. Obviously. Antenna is focusing like that and they are around that so whatever the radiations are coming they are focusing on the center so that the gain has been increased so this is the type of scene in many home installation from the reception of TV signal. हम बार-बार वही बात करते हैं. We have seen already at the homes. हमने घर पे देखा हुआ है. We have this one. The smaller dish antenna typically operates somewhere between 2 to 28 gigahertz. The large dish can operate in the VHF region 30 to 300 megahertz. So that we know that as the size of the antenna reduces, as the size of the antenna reduces, obviously we can operate with the higher frequencies. और जब हमारा जो size है, antenna का जो size है, वो बढ़ता है, तो हम low frequencies operate करते हैं. तो जो बड़ी डिश एंटीनाज जो आप देखते हैं, बहुत बड़े वाले होते हैं, जो पहले केबल टीवीज के लिए छतों पे लगे होते थे केबल ऑपरेटर्स के पास में, तो वो लो फ्रीक्वेंसीज मेगाहर्ट्ज ऑर्डर के होते थे. अब D2H पे काम कर दो, यू आर नाउ वर्किंग एंड कैपेबल टू वर्क ऑन विद द हाई रेंज ऑफ द फ्रीक्वेंसीज. यू आर कैपेबल टू वर्क ऑन विद द हाई रेंज ऑफ द फ्रीक्वेंसीज. ऑल दोस हाई रेंज ऑफ द फ्रीक्वेंसीज आर इजीली ऑपरेबल विद द हेल्प ऑफ द पैराबोलिक डिश रिफ्लेक्टर्स. आप आराम से इनको यूज कर सकते हैं. इफ यू सी हियर, ये रहा आपका D2H एंटीना. देयर इज अ डिश वी आर यूजिंग हियर. वी आर हैविंग द हॉर्न स्ट्रक्चर. यहां पर आपका हॉर्न होता है. सो सी इफ यू टॉक अबाउट दिस वन, तो दिस पर्टिकुलर हॉर्न एंटीना कैन इजीली वर्क विद द हाई गीगाहर्ट्ज फ्रीक्वेंसीज. इट मींस अ वेरिंग फ्रॉम द 20 टू 30 गीगाहर्ट्ज फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो दोस आर पॉसिबल विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस रिफ्लेक्टर. एंड दिस रिफ्लेक्टर इज डूइंग नथिंग, हॉर्न के रेडिएशंस को रिसेप्शंस को कंबाइंड कर रहा है. इट इज डूइंग सिर्फ एक अपर्चर इंक्रीज कर रहा है. रेडिएशन आएंगे, टकराएंगे, रिफ्लेक्ट करेगा, रिफ्लेक्ट करके हॉर्न को देगा लो. यू आर फीलिंग लो इन एनर्जी. अगर आपको एनर्जी कम है, वी आर गिविंग एनर्जी टू यू. सो दिस इज बेसिकली द बेनिफिट ऑफ दिस स्ट्रक्चर. टॉकिंग अबाउट बेसिकली द एडवांटेज ऑफ द पैराबोलिक रिफ्लेक्टर एंटीना, द मेन एडवांटेज ऑफ द पैराबोलिक एंटीना इज दैट इट हैज अ हाई डायरेक्टिविटी. ऑब्वियसली इट इज इन हियर जस्ट ओनली टू इंप्रूव द गेन और डायरेक्टिविटी. इट फिट्स वेल फॉर नॉइजी लोकेशन where other antennas factually do not work. Easily वहाँ fix हो जाता है जहाँ पर ये noisy होता है, because it is just only concentrating. इसको बाहर से मतलब ही नहीं है, इसके पास से अगल से कुछ भी निकल जाए कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा. It is just only concentrating towards one. क्योंकि parabolic अपने focus पर ही, जो उसका focal point होता है, it always radiates on the focal point. So this is a very good advantage. Receive radio waves from one particular direction only. और एक ही डायरेक्शन में जिस तरफ फोकस किया जा रहा है, इसका फेस फोकस किया जा रहा है, इट इज ओनली वर्किंग इन दैट, नॉट रिसीविंग फ्रॉम द बैक साइड. दिस इज आल्सो एन एडवांटेज, सो दैट अननेसेसरी सिग्नल्स कमिंग फ्रॉम द बैक साइड दैट आर नॉट ऑफ यूज, उसका कोई मतलब ही नहीं है, कोई यूज ही नहीं. सो दिस इज ऑल एक्चुअली द गुड थिंग दैट वी एसोसिएट दिस रिफ्लेक्टर विद द मेन एंटीना. इस तरीके से हम एंटीना को एसोसिएट करते हैं, ठीक है. एंड मेनी टाइम वी हैव दिस डबल रिफ्लेक्टर एंटीनास टू. So we'll discuss about this double reflector antenna. Let's talk about it a little. So double reflector, it means with the reflector type of antenna, the feeder connecting with the feed horn to the transmitter receiving equipment must be kept as short as possible to minimize loss. It means you having basically a double side of the reflector. Like if you see here, so in this particular, these are the wire connected with the horn, and here you are just having a center point which is just creating a noise here. So talking about this one, so this double reflector antenna is capable to reflect in both the side. So what you are doing, you are doing nothing but you are using a two reflector antennas like this one in this way. So you are connecting your antennas in this way so that you just have a two side facing by which you can easily reflect and receive. So that's why they are just talking about with reflector type antennas, the feeder connecting to the feed horn to the transmit receiver equipment must be kept as a short as possible to minimize. ये minimize the losses करने के लिए एक special effects बता रहे हैं, but it's a very simple kind of like a double reflector. So well, here we are just concluding. So we had a target to just understand about today's lecture, like what are basically the antenna attributes. So we talked about basically what exactly the antenna, what is the importance of an antenna, what range of the frequency of the antenna is required, what should be the gain of the antenna. If suppose we are talking about the whole accessories of the antenna, so what are the things? So within the antenna system, we should have some horn antenna, we should have some reflector antenna. By association, this we can have. And also we have gone through the complete communication from input signal to the output signal via satellite mode. So we have just gone through this block diagram. I hope so during all of this process, you might be able to understand the functioning and the working of all these antennas and their importance too. So meanwhile, this session is open for any sort of the question. If you feel, you may ask.